Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to use map charts in Excel to create a map directly in your spreadsheet. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. So before we start, some important things to know about the map chart feature in Excel. First, currently, this is available only in newer versions of Excel, so 2016 or better, or if you use one of the online subscriptions. And for now, there are only two types of map charts you can make in Excel. So either based on values, for example, dollars, or by category, and an example would be by product. Now you can only have one variable in a map. So you couldn't map, for example, dollars spent and dollars generated. You would have to map one or the other. And as far as the geography you can plot, it's currently only available to do higher level geographies. That is, you can't currently plot individual addresses. And if you use counties or cities, there's a chance you could get incorrect data if other counties or cities share the same name as the one on your data list. In this case, you could add a column for country, but for this example, we'll be using zip codes. And also, the mapping in this type of chart is supported by Bing Maps. So while you can add or remove data from your data set, to update the map, you'll need an internet connection so that your map can connect with Bing Maps. So as with any technology, these things could change. I wanted to make you aware of some potential limitations as of the time of this recording. So what you see on my screen are zip codes in the Miami area, Florida, along with some products and the amount of dollars each product generated in that zip code. So let's first make a category map. To map the data, select the data that you would like to map. And keep in mind, you can only select one variable at a time. So I'm highlighting the zip code and the product because this is a category map. Then in your Insert tab, go to the chart section and click on Maps. Once you have your map chart, double-click on it to bring up your map options. This will bring up the usual options for changing the fill, color, shading, and other types of formatting. So if you double click on the actual map, not the space around it, you'll also see options for formatting the type of map. And map projections are types of map layouts. If you'd like to know more about them, I included more info on each in the description of this video. The map area is how much of a map you'd like to show. So you can show a world map, multiple countries of the region. You can show just the country where your data is, the state or province, or what we're going to choose, only the region with data. You can then select if you'd like to display labels. In this case, the labels are the zip code. I'm actually not going to select them for now. Instead, we'll come up here to the plus sign on the map and select data labels, more data label options to get, well, more options. So here we can decide if we want to see the series name, the category name, and or the value, and then how we'd like to separate these, if we want to separate them by comma, semicolon, period, a new line, or a space. But I'm only going to display the value, which in this case is our product names. So the second type of map, a value map, is very much like a heat map. So using the same data as in our last example, our data is still highlighted, but if it wasn't, I would just select the chart to highlight it. And I'm going to drag the highlight on product to dollars sold. So notice how the legend has changed to a gradient shading based on the dollar amount. This means that the higher the amount of dollars sold, the darker that area will be on my map. So again, by double-clicking on just the map, I can bring up options for how much geography I'd like to show on this map. So I'm again going to select only regions with data. So from here, you have the same options as in our last example as far as formatting your map and if you would like to see any labels for your map. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to add a map chart in Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks!